We got a cool fade-in effect. We've got a cinematic pan, courtesy of my Pixel 6 Pro, run around on this cool Duplo train. What are we looking at here? This is the one and only Motorola Solid State Echo Show 9. Yeah, that's right. It's a Motorola TV made in Japan by a factory that was soon to be bought by Matsushita in the early 70s. Yeah, and inside of it is an Echo Show 8. So, yeah, this TV came off of eBay for 50 bucks shipped. It's a good deal, but it didn't work. I plugged it in, nothing happened. When I took it apart, I found a blown fuse and decided I was a little scared to get any farther into it. Yeah, so I went to Best Buy, checked out all the different Amazon Echo Shows and Dots and speakers and what they got. And this little guy sounded really good. Decided, yeah, so we'll start with the Echo Show 8. It doesn't have a line out. The first gen did, second gen does not. Next, started taking apart this TV, and I was gentle at first, but yeah, gentle went out the window pretty quickly. Those little snips with the blue handles end up being the hero of this whole show, doing a lot of work. But after I get all the junk out of the TV, I'm pretty happy with what I'm left with. I got this big metal chassis that's going to hold the whole thing together, and the front and the back go together pretty well. So here's a picture tube, CRT, and front plate, it's in okay shape. It's got tape over the speaker. I used to do that when I was a kid. I put cellophane tape over the speaker to knock out the mid-range, make the bass sound a little bit more pronounced. There's the chassis I was talking about. The channel selectors are huge, but I love the action, so we're going to keep most of it. Back, plugs and stuff, we're going to use as decorations. There's that metal hoop that held the CRT in place. So I'm a little scared to take apart this Echo. So I look online, try to figure out what it is I'm exactly doing. The bottom rubber-coated plate, pries right off. There's adhesive holding it in. Yep, then a few Torx screws, and we're off to the races. So a couple of big PCBs show up here. One is the power and USB interface board. It had a headset jack, like where you could solder one on, but my oscilloscope was showing nothing coming out of those. On the other side of that, there's a microphone board, and the buttons actually connect through that. So sort of a daisy chained couple of little boards through flex cables. Yep, then the speaker wires coming out there. They're pretty good. They did what I needed them to do. They're thick enough. The CPU you can see covered in blue thermal interface material. I was a little surprised to see that, but yeah, then I felt how hot it got. It's like, okay, let me get a heatsink for that. Because it used to connect to a giant sheet of copper tape on the back of that speaker enclosure. But that wasn't going to be there anymore. Yeah, so I got this heatsink. I had gotten it off of Amazon for a SSD. So I hook up the speakers here just for a test. And basically, yeah, just grab a speaker from my computer and plug the Amazon Echo Show into it. It was hot and sizzling, and the treble is pretty distorted. I was disappointed how much distortion there was. Anyway, so now it's bath day. I try to get all these stickers off. I do okay. Maybe I should have tried steaming them. But I ended up, just covering them with packing tape and getting a razor underneath as best as I could. Some of them came off, some of them not as much. And I'm trying to clean off a bunch of, old who knows what. But then finally that tape on the front that I mentioned earlier, that little bit of cellophane tape over the speaker grill, that ended up being a problem. I tested the corners of that front plate with the goof off, which is a pretty strong solvent. Didn't notice any problems. I'm like, I'll get this tape off. And when I poured a little extra goof off on it, it just ripped the paint right off. So I got this big bare spot on the front. I was really disappointed. I was hoping to keep it a little bit more original looking, but We deal with it later, and you'll see how. Alright, so now we're going to try to get the Echo Show display mounted on the front of that TV. I start with some various bits of pine that I had laying around. These trim pieces end up working really well. Just needed a little bit of trimming. Had to shave one down in order to get the buttons and microphone PCBs and to fit in there. So then you can see I'm marking a little template for where I need to drill holes to move the buttons to the front of the TV plate. And that it actually was fine except for the countersinking. So the plastic on the TV was really thick. The buttons didn't quite, you know, reach above it. So I had to thin it out by countersinking with a bigger drill bit. Maybe there's a better way to do it, but I ended up taking off some paint around the edges. And it just didn't look very clean. I thought maybe there was something I could do to paint circles around them. I didn't end up touching it up. I left it as it is. So we got these countersunk buttons. They work great. Microphones seem to work really well too. I've checked them for echo and, you know, tried commands while loud music's playing. They were fine. Right, so get the shims in place, screw it all together. Those flex cables are really hard to connect in there, but yeah, it was just a really tight spot. So let's see, I seem to be playing a Roblox game. Maybe I'm getting a high score. I connected the USB and power connect board at the bottom there. That ended up being in the way of the speakers, so I move it later. But yeah, I want to get that mounted down so I don't tear it, because that power cable is always connected and, you know, I'm pulling on it. But I finally got it closed up with a speaker on the inside. That speaker came out of a Gateway 2000 computer from the mid-90s. It sounds fine. The foam surround, it's still in one piece, but it seemed like a time bomb. So I went to Craigslist, found these local speakers for sale. They are the Pioneer SPBS22LRs, which is Andrew Jones's thing. Probably going to take that sticker and slap it on the back of the TV. Audio Artistry by Andrew Jones. So I grabbed those speakers, and the woofers, the full range kind of woofer, it's 4-inch, sound great. The tweeters are super hot on this Echo Show. I'm guessing they're trying to compensate for, you know, lack of high end on those 2-inch full range speakers that it came with. Yeah, so I went through, I tried a bunch of different, you know, candidates as tweeters, but I couldn't get any to work right. So I wasn't sure what I was going to do about the audio. So I got these, you know, nice speakers and crossovers, and I start futzing around. Anyway, okay, so I got to get the, got to make room for a speaker box in the back. I decided I'm not going to close up the whole TV and make it a speaker enclosure. I'm going to build an enclosure in the inside. So I take the channel changers and I take the metal chassis and I grind down anything I don't really need. There's some spots where, you know, there's some connectors that just could go away on the sides of that. So I framed this metal chassis out as bare as I could, and then I build this little cardboard, you know, dummy of a speaker cabinet. Start using it as a template to build the box itself out of this MDF. This is some half-inch MDF I stole from a cat tower that had been retired. You know, my budget is as small as possible, so it was a good deal that I hadn't thrown that one out yet. So yeah, so I built a speaker cabinet. The lid, the corner's a little too thin, so I ended up breaking it as I screwed down the speakers. The second version of it, I was a little more careful. But this one, even though the corner's cracked, it was sealed well enough to at least get some idea of what I was working with. And it sounded great until I put it inside the TV cabinet. As soon as I put it inside the TV cabinet, it sounded like a mess. It was like a seashell inside of a tin cup, you know, just echoey, resonating, weird resonance sounds. So I put some more holes in the TV. I kind of, you know, extend some of the vents that are in the back. And it got it to sound kind of okay. I thought about leaving it just that, just as it was, and preserve it to be as original looking as possible. But yeah, so I get frustrated with the sound, and I start working on the cosmetics. So you can see the antenna connector, and here's an old power connector and a power switch in the back. Those need to go on the back of the speaker box, so I start attaching those. The speaker box, it got glued and filled with fiberglass at some point. You can see the version 2 of the top is there. I've got the speaker sunk into it a little bit. I use this walnut sticker, essentially. It's like a wallpaper. Found that on Amazon pretty cheap, and ended up saving the day with the outside of the box. So I'm buttoning this up, and you know, I got the speaker wires there. You know, I'm going without no crossover, no tweeters, just sticking it in the box and hoping for the best. You can see I've got a port tuned on the back there. It's a little too small. It's a 3/4 inch port. Probably needed to be, you know, twice the diameter. Oh, and I try to stick, I want to get the power in there. I want to get the power connector inside there so I can just have 120 volts going in, but it didn't fit. And not only did it not fit, but I end up breaking the flex cable out, the one that goes between the main logic board and the microphone board. So both, well, all four microphones and the buttons stop working, which, yeah, that was sad. Luckily, nothing was permanently broken. I was able to reseat the cable on the main logic board and reconnect it to the microphone board, and it was fine. But I didn't think the warranty claim was going to go very well if I was going to go back to Amazon and ask for a new one. All right, so I'm buttoning this thing up. I'm sure it's fine. It's fine. I'm going to be happy with the sound. I'm not really. You can hear, here's a sample of it. So this is closed up. It just sounds like you're in a cup. And then I take the back off. I love the way it sounds. Sounds great. It's a little bit hot, a little sizzly, but it's fine. And then I built a cardboard, you know, facsimile of the case. And the reason I did that was to try to get that same terrible tin cup sound. And then I was going to hack at it with scissors and razors until I made it sound good. And what it took was a couple of giant holes in the top. So that's why I cut those two giant holes in the top of the TV and forged, you know, put together some metal speaker grates to fit in there. And now it sounds pretty good. Except, oh yeah, I remember I put a scarf in the back of the TV to try to knock out some of the resonance. Now it's just killing the high end. So I take that out. Now I'm really happy. This is it. This is what it's going to do. So I epoxied those grills flush and covered the whole thing with a walnut sticker. And then I poked 400 holes through that walnut sticker to make it look like a speaker grill that was nice and flush. So you can see it there. I've got the, you know, a bunch of holes on the top. The sides are now the wood grain sticker. And the front, you can see it was also covered with a wood grain sticker to cover up that giant hole in the paint. I did not bother putting the holes back in the front for the speaker. I think it looks fine without those. You know, so I'm measuring, like, how does it sound? You know, what's the, you know, how loud is it? I guess about 100 dB. Listen, I've got, it's raining tacos up there. you know, it's a fun sound. It's got enough bass to be entertaining. It's got plenty of loudness to rock or, you know, listen to EDM or whatever. Yeah, and it's together, and it's done. It looks cool with that antenna. Don't try this at home. This is a pain. Don't do it. Thanks.
Hey Google, how do I restore faded plastic?